Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com. Welcome back to my channel, the number one place for iOS developers who want to code smarter. In today's video, I am going to demystify navigation in SwiftUI. If you are interested in learning all the mysteries of navigation, then keep on watching. Now, most of you know my style by now, so hit that subscribe button, open Xcode, and let's dive in. Alrighty then. Let's take a look at our demo project so you can see what we are going to build out today. So here we have a play button and a home navigation title. And we have some other stuff here going on and of course a label. And let's take a look at our sheet finally. Awesome. So this is what we are going to build out today. So let's jump right into it. You can take a look at the source code on my GitHub repository. All the links are down below. So here is my starter project. I have created some constants here for the SF symbols, so I don't have to go ahead and just find them. And I already have the content view. It's just simply hello world, detail view, and the profile view. That is it. So what we are going to build out today is the navigations. So let's just jump right into our content view and let's create, first of all, a navigation view. And inside our navigation view, first of all, let's create a Z stack. So now you will know how to create a Z stack because I want to add a background color and that will be our color of red. Okay, and while we are here, let me just add in here our canvas so we can see what's going on in the content view. Let's hit resume and restart. Okay, so here we have our color red. What we want to add next is our navigation views bar title. So after the Z stack, and yeah, you can see that it's kind of it's having a lot of issues, but we will fix those later on. So first of all, let us add our title, bar title. So under the Z stack, let's add a modifier of title, and that is navigation bar title, and let's use the one with the text. Okay, and let's call this home. Let's wait for the preview. Let's hit resume. You will see that the home navigation bar title will appear right here. There we go. But we want to have that nice red background to cover all of our screen. So for that, after the navigation view has closed, let's add a modifier to edges, and edges ignoring safe area. That's what we want to choose. Then we'll choose all. Okay, you may choose, but all is okay with us. Okay, now as you can see, our home is pushed all the way up, but we will fix that real soon. So what we want to do is grab our navigation bar title and remove it from our Z stack and just add it to our navigation. Okay, there. Return, and we should be all fine. Okay, so for this to actually work, we still need to add our navigation link. So that is what we are going to add right now. So we have a navigation link. So here I'm going to add in an image system name, and I'm just going to use my constants fs symbol name dot. And I will choose the play circle fill. Okay, I want to add a font of, let's say, large title, and let's say a foreground color of white, or foreground color dot white. Okay, let's see if the preview is going to work. So let's add a destination for this navigation link. And that will be our detail view. Let's see if the preview is okay. We do have this button here. So next up, let's add a text below our button. And I will add this into the navigation link because let's say we tapped on the text. We wanted that to lead to the next view.
So the text string will be, let's say, play or something like that. There we go. And we should have a foreground color of white. So I'm just going to grab this foreground color and just add it to our navigation link. That should work. Okay, great. Now we have all of this in white. Furthermore, as you can see, now these two modifiers are on the navigation view, but I just recall that all of this needs to be added onto our view that is inside our navigation view, and that is our Z stack. So there we go, I'm just copying and pasting there, and voila, everything is working A-OK as we might have expected. Okay, so let's just build and run and see if our play button does show our detail view. Okay, let's just wait for that and see that we do have our home here, our play, and there we go. We have our back button, of course, because we are coming from home. We have our home as the text of our back button. We have our detail and we have our label here. So let's just jump right into our detail view and work some more. I will just close the canvas in the detail view because we don't need it here. So what we want to do here is add these two buttons, and I will just show you what I mean. Let me just open up the demo project here. And as you can see, we have these two bar button items. And that is pretty simple to add. After the navigation bar title, let's add another modifier, and that is navigation bar button items. And we are going to add to our trailing of our navigation. So let's select that. Let me just add return here. So we are going to add in here a view. And of course, we want to add more than one button. So we are going to add in here a horizontal stack, so H stack. And inside this H stack, I'm going to add two images. So image, system name. So let's wait for the auto completion. And I'm just going to use SF symbol name. And for the first one, I'm going to use the heart. So suit heart fill, and let's have a font of let's say title dot title, and let's have a foreground color of dot red. Okay, and let's duplicate this for now, and let's change our heart to our profile. So that is person circle fill. Okay, and I will change. Oh, let's leave the foreground color for now. Okay, so let's add in here our image because we forgot that. There we go. All of these should go away. Okay, and finally, I want to add in here a spacing of 50. So next up, what we want to do is, can see here we have two images, and I want to, let's just indent this correctly, so Control I. So on the second image, I want to have a button. So let's create our button here, so button, and that button will have an action, and for now let us just print out button tab. So let's add these two parentheses and add in our image, Alt command and a square bracket. And let's delete that one line of code. Let me just grab all of these with Control I, and we have our button here. And what we want to do on this button is show a sheet. So let's just type in sheet is presented. And as you can see, we have a binding and a content. So the content is pretty easy. Let's just add in here the next view, and that is our profile view that we want to show. Now the binding, it needs to be before we declare our body, and that will be an @state variable, and we'll call this is profile view presented, and the default value is false. Okay, and we just add this to our binding with a $ is profile view presented. Now of course this is false by default, so it will not show when we tap on that button, so we want to change the is profile view presented value to true when the button is tapped, so inside the action. So let me just do that after we print out button tapped. So is profile view presented equals true. True. Let's see if this compiles, and we should be ready. Oh, we need to add in here self because we are in a closure. So let's hit the play button here. So the problem here was that we omitted this system name when we created our image. And of course the person circle field wasn't inside our asset catalog. So yeah, good debugging here. And I will remove this foreground color red while we are at it, because I want to make that the default black. So let's play, or rather yet, hit build and run on the Xcode project and see this in the simulator. So let's hit play, and there we go. Here we have our profile, but it is blue, the default blue. So I will add in here for our button, I will just add in here, let's see, foreground color of black. Okay, that should do it. And finally, I want to have this detail, not this large navigation bar title. Okay, so I'm just delete and start typing title. And what we are going to use is not this one with just the title, we are going to use display mode. So there we go, detail. And for the display mode, we have automatic, of course it inherits, inline or large. We are going to use inline here. So let's build and run one final time, and we should be ready with our project. I know it's a lot of modifiers here, but I really do like modifiers, and let me know if you like modifiers, go ahead and give me a rocket down below in the comments. Let's hit play here, and there we go, here we have our profile, and awesome. And of course, we can slide up and down this, and I believe I have, in the meantime, while I was debugging, I was taking a look at the constants, so person dot circle fill. That is how it should be. And let me just take a look at the profile view. There are of course a lot of modifiers here, some paddings, some images and spacers, but we are going to talk about all of this in later tutorials. If you want to take a look at the code, go ahead and click the link down below for the GitHub repository. So one final time, here we have play, detail, we can go back, clicking on home, play, here we have our profile showing up as a sheet. And that is it for today's awesome navigation tips video.
Now you know all the secrets of navigation in SwiftUI. If you are more interested in SwiftUI tutorials, make sure to hit the notification bell, because in my next video I am going to talk about animations in SwiftUI. This is gonna be a really cool video where I'm gonna share some awesome animation tips and sequences. So make sure to hit that notification bell so you don't miss that video. In the meantime, while you wait for that video, make sure you also check out these two videos that I have over here. I talk a lot about iOS development, SwiftUI, and how to code smarter. So make sure to check out these videos as well. And as always, I will see you in the next one.